say you let me down. But he's been here before, come back around. Will he take you to the same place? Want my heart back in your bookcase? You got that look in your eyes.
It's your city news at 9:30. I'm Sheila Bucket.
And I'm Dax von Carmichael Bartholomew Davenport XIV. This just in, an earthquake has occurred in the middle of the Atlantic Ocean. And according to the United States Geological Survey, it registered a record-breaking 9.8 on the Richter scale.
The earthquake is expected to cause a catastrophic mega tsunami, measuring 900 feet in height and making landfall in New York City, very close to Joe's Pub. It will destroy most of the east coast of the United States, North Africa, Europe, South America, Asia, and Australia.
So, just to clarify, we're all gonna die?
That's right, Dax. We're all gonna fucking die.
Come on in, we begin at the end. The last night on earth. Come on in, we begin at the end. The last night on earth. Come on in, we begin at the end. The last night on earth.
Oh, it's the last night on earth. The time has come to say goodbye. So let's get together and celebrate, because we're all gonna fucking die. Oh, it's the last night on earth. But don't be sad, we don't know what comes next. Yes, we're all gonna die, but what if death is fun? No one knows, so relax and enjoy. So we're gonna get together, have a good time. Gonna leave all our worries behind. 'Cause this really could be the last time that we all get to do this together. I want this last night to
unless we're all gonna fucking die. That's right, we're all gonna fucking die. That's right, we're all gonna motherfucking die.
Die together tonight. Isn't that crazy?
It's the last night of Earth.
We're so honored that you chose to spend your last breaths with us here at Joe's Pub.
Yeah, it's really special.
When we found out that it was the last night on Earth, that there was going to be the tsunami that was going to destroy most of humanity, we got really, really sad.
We went through all the emotions.
We got angry.
Anger.
We cried a lot.
Terror. Grief. And then I called up Matt and I said, you know what I think we should do? We should put on a show.
Yeah. And I was like, what kind of show?
Yeah, and I said a variety show.
Okay.
We should give all of our talented artistic friends an opportunity to have a swan song, perform, share their art for the very last time. And so that's what we're here to do, because we could focus on all the scary stuff.
Yeah, but we're not going to.
But we're not going to do that.
We're going to celebrate life. And
it's Nadia, been great.
Nadia thought it would be a really good idea if we did something super scary to start off.
Yeah, so it's our last chance to perform tonight. And I said, well, I have unfulfilled rock star dreams. And I think we should do something terrifying, because that, like, there's no stakes anymore.
Right, yeah, we're all going to die. So, like, let's just do the things we never would have done before. Like, for example, the song we're about to sing, which if you Google most difficult song in the world to sing, this is literally what comes up.
Okay, but let me tell you, it's also really fun. And Matt used that as, like, trying to convince me we shouldn't sing this.
I took a picture of it, I screenshot it, and I sent it to her. I said,
he was like, this is why we can't sing this song. And I was like, that's why we have to sing this song.
So I'm doing this completely against my will. You guys can sing along with us if you want.
If you want.
You're all going to die, so just sing along. It's great.
But tonight's going to be a big celebration, and we're just really grateful that you're here with us. So.
All right, here we go.
Here we go.
Is this the real life? Is this just fantasy? Caught in a landslide, no escape from reality. Open your eyes, look up to the skies and see. I'm just a poor boy, I need no sympathy. Because I'm easy come, easy go, little high, little low. Any way the wind blows doesn't really matter to me. To me. Mama, I just killed a man. Put a gun against his head, pull my trigger, now he's dead. Mama, life had just begun, and now I've gone and thrown it all away. Mama, ooh, didn't mean to make you cry. If I'm not back again, it's time to borrow. Carry on, as if nothing really matters. Too late, my time has come. Send shivers down my spine. Body's aching all the time. Goodbye, everybody. I've got to go. Gotta leave you all behind and face the truth. Mama, ooh, I don't wanna die. I sometimes wish I'd never. Thank you.
a little silhouette of a man.
Scaramouche,
Scaramouche, will you do the fandango? Thunderbolt and lightning, very, very frightening me.
Galileo,
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 Galileo Figaro,
Magnifico.
I'm just a poor boy, nobody loves me.
He's just a poor boy from a poor family, sparing his life from this monstrosity.
Easy come, easy go, will you let me go?
Bismillah, no, we will not let you go.
Let him go!
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let him go!
Bismillah, we will not let you go.
Let me go!
We'll not let you go.
Let me go!
We'll not let you go.
Go!
Go, 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 go!
Mamma mia, mamma mia, mamma mia, let me go!
He has a mom, has a devil put aside for me. Nothing really matters. Nothing really matters to me.
Nothing fucking matters. That's
because
we're
gonna die.
That's
guys.
The whole point, you guys.
That felt great.
It honestly did.
Anyway, the wind.
Okay.
And to our band, like, we would have sounded terrible without that band. Well, like, medium good. That's cool. Wow. Well, now we can go out having rock and rolled.
Yeah, we did. We did that.
Yeah.
We did that.
We did that.
Okay.
Okay, so next, we're going to bring on our first guest. So right. We have some really special guests tonight.
Yeah, we invited a whole bunch of friends to join us to celebrate.
I feel like you need to be closer to that.
Okay, sorry. Thank you. Here. So our first guest gave me instructions on how to introduce her. So I have to...
Oh, yeah.
Okay, our next guest is a veteran of the stage. Her extensive credits include the Broadway shows Let's Try the Other House and the musical We Met on Tiptoes, for which she received a Tony nomination. However, the bulk of Pam's... I just revealed her name, sorry. Pam's career has been...
Her name's
Pam. It's written here. Has been in theaters all across the country. She has appeared in every major regional theater, often more than once. In fact, she just wrapped up a production of The Humans at the Ends of the Earth Dinner Theater. Please welcome
Pam Goldberg. Wow. That's for you, Pam.
So I'm standing, is what you're saying.
Oh, would you rather sit? We have
no,
a stool.
No, that's fine. That's okay. Fine. I hope I'm not dressed too casually. I figured if I'm going to die, I might as well be comfortable.
No, that's fine. You look great.
Where did you get this scarf? Actually?
At a Dollar Tree, but a good one.
Oh.
Maplewood, New Jersey. Too late now, but it was good.
Pam, where is the Ends of the Earth Dinner Theater?
I think it's in northern Arizona. I'm not sure. Oh. I'm flown to Albuquerque, and then a 16-year-old picks me up in a van and drives me for 3 hours. Wow. The housing is terrific, and that's why I go back. You don't remember me, do you, Matt?
Wait, have we met before?
Yes, we did a production of The Normal Heart, It was a while ago. It was after 9/11, but before Kale. Yes. So I can't...
I remember.
I'm not sure what year that was.
At a theater that shall not be named.
The Coconut Grove Playhouse.
Oh, well, we just named it.
Defunct. We did good work, but people were more interested in parasailing, I think.
I thought you were really good, actually.
I thought I was, too. I was the doctor who was very upset about AIDS.
So, Pam, how are you feeling about the last night on Earth?
Well, it's, you know, I was about to turn 80 this year. Not going to do that anymore. So I've spent a great deal of the recent past with more past behind me than future. So I've been thinking about the past a whole lot, you know, and my experiences and you know, I was always a look straight ahead, you know, or, you know, what's next on the docket type gal. But I've been reminiscing a lot about my past.
And speaking of your past, what is the very first theater?
Yeah, what was your first job?
My first job was a summer of summer stock at the Northland Playhouse in Saugatuck, Michigan. I did.
Okay.
Oh, Michigan's in the house. You got out too. We made it. I did 8 shows in 9 weeks. The lead... That's what you did back then. The lead actor was Cesar Romero. He played the Joker on the old Batman television series. In fact, opening night of a show that I wasn't in much of Act 1, I was in my dressing room doing my crossword puzzle. Uh-huh. Cesar's on stage. He runs into the dressing room, slams the door, sees me, and says, "Pam, I need you." I thought, oh boy, here we go. He staggers towards me, feeling, you know, my midsection with his hands. I thought we were getting into a Me Too moment, but no. He said, "I need you. I need your help. There's something in my eye." He needed me to administer eye wash, and I did. And he said, "Thanks a lot, kid," and he ran back on stage, finishing the show. He slapped me on the ass on my way out, but that was like a handshake back then.
Right, of course, of course. Okay, we're asking everyone sort of this question. Is there anything that you would like to do before you die?
Yes, yes. And I'm so grateful for you indulging me in this, but I have a letter that I wrote to my mother as a young person.
Okay.
And I never sent it to her. And I'd love to read it for all of you tonight.
Yeah,
if that's all right. Here we go. I need my hands to open it.
No better time than tonight.
Thank you. Thank you all in advance for this. It means a lot to me. I appreciate the support. She's long gone, as we all will be shortly. March 12th, 1973. Dear Mother, I'm writing this letter from the basement of the Winter Garden Theater. Not that you'd have any idea where that is, you miserable cunt. I'm appearing on Broadway in a new musical, We Met on Tiptoes, which I'm certain is going to be a great success. We closed in 2 weeks. That's neither here nor there. I'm working with artists who are at the top of their craft. My director, Sham Hepworth, he's more than pleased with my performance. Our opening night party is at Sardi's, a place I've always wanted to go but felt silly going alone. For once in this crazy profession, everything's going well. So why do I feel insufficient? I get huge laughs every night in my role of Comrade Janice, the lovable communist. But I see you in the back of the house with your arms folded, rolling your eyes. I see you in my dressing room, wincing at the sight of my hips as I get out of my costume. And I hear your voice every time I take a nap between shows to think my daughter sleeping on a cot. Mother, I resent the fact that you haunt me in this way. It is keeping me from fully experiencing the joy and accomplishment of this particular moment of my life. There's a popular movie out right now, and it's called The Exorcist. In it, an actress is shocked to discover that her daughter is possessed by Satan. So she hires an exorcist to help her out. Well, this actress has a mother, you, who I often wonder is and was possessed by Satan. However, I can't afford to hire an exorcist, even on a Broadway salary. Something's never changed, right? But what I can finally do now is write these words and mean them. Fuck you. Fuck you for making me believe my only option in life was marrying and having children. Fuck you for not giving me a sibling, therefore never having someone to speak up for me. Fuck you for emasculating an already passive man to begin with. Talking about my dad here. Fuck you for making me wear that orange dress to picture day. Fuck you for saying no to piano lessons. Fuck you for being a bad cook and making me endure nearly 20 years of horrible food. Fuck you for your bad singing voice. Fuck you for your mean laugh. And finally, fuck you for not believing me when I told you Uncle Scott molested me when he drove me to the New York to see Mary Martin and Peter Pan. Peter Pan was a great show. The road trip wasn't great. Even writing these words down, I feel empowered and as though a weight has been lifted off my shoulders. I did nothing wrong, Mother. So why did you always make me feel as though I had? Who hurt you? I shudder to think of what your father was like and am grateful for having never known him. In photos, he always reminded me of Vincent Price, who always gave me the creeps. I met him later years ago. Couldn't have been a nicer man. I hope you read and reread this letter over and over. I hope it haunts your every waking moment. I hope it makes you stop and wonder why your only child got the hell away from you as soon as she could. Finally, I hope I have the courage to send this letter to you, after all. Regards, your daughter, Pam. P.S. I'm about to go perform for 1,600 people. That's 1,600 people more who love me than you. That's it.
Wow.
Pam.
Thank you so much.
Good. Does that feel good to get that off your chest?
It feels really good. It feels really good.
What was your mom's name?
Henrietta.
Oh, well,
can I ask one more question?
Yeah.
Just what, since tonight's your last night, is there any food that you're going to have tonight before, like, what's your last meal going to be today?
I'm going to eat as much as humanly possible.
Just of anything. Okay. Just curious.
Yes. Thank you all so much.
Pam Goldberg, everybody.
See you on the other side.
Thank you, Pam.
That got a little darker than I was expecting.
Yeah, but, you know...
Some dark memories with Henrietta.
I think that was... It was healthy for her to get that off
her chest. I think so, too. Yeah. It's good to confess things.
Okay, so, you guys, we have this awkward thing where we have to do these commercials.
Oh, yeah, we couldn't afford to do the show without taking on a couple corporate sponsors. It turns out at the end of the world, capitalism is still raging strong.
So they gave us these scripts.
We haven't read these yet. We just have to...
You can play them all.
Okay, I'll be this, you be that guy.
Okay,
so these are just some commercials. Take them or leave them. Okay. I'm just looking at it. Here we go. I'm a busy mom, and my first priority is to keep my kids safe. That's why when I heard the world was ending and there was a 2% chance we'd all survive and have to live in a post-apocalyptic landscape, I purchased the Johnson & Johnson Survival Backpack for my kids. It includes everything you need to survive practically anything. A rope and a tarp for building shelters, a compass for finding their way through the rubble and wreckage, fire starters for starting fires, and knives.
The Johnson & Johnson Survival Backpack also includes Band-Aids, iodine, flashlights, batteries, dehydrated food, suicide pills, Xanax, a tourniquet, a crossbow, and so much more.
Wow.
Mom, what's this bone saw for?
Well, that's for gutting animals or people if food becomes so scarce you have to turn to cannibalism.
Oh. The Johnson & Johnson Survival Backpack. Get it now before, well, before stores don't exist anymore.
Johnson & Johnson Survival Backpack.
Wow. We just knew that little song just somehow. So our next guest...
Yes. Oh, we actually two guests.
Two guests. Very dear friends of ours.
And they are also their best friends, they wanted to spend their last night on Earth together.
And one of them, Matt, hate to out you here, but is your lover.
Yes, that's right.
One of Matt's lover. So that's lucky. Yeah.
So everyone, please welcome to the stage...
Greg Hildreth and John Riddle, Matt's lover!
Thank you. Bodies be bosom bodies, friends, sisters, and pals. We'll always be bosom bodies. If life should reject you, there's me to protect you. If I say that your tongue is vicious, if I call you uncouth, it's simply that. Who else but a bosom body will sit down and tell you the truth? I feel it's my duty to tell you that it's time to adjust to your age. You try to be Juliet when you're Lady Macbeth. Exactly how old are you, Vera? The truth.
Well, how old do you think?
I'd say somewhere between 40 and death.
But sweetie,
who else but a bosom body will sit down and level and give you the devil? Will sit down and tell you you're nothing without me. Without me, you just disappear right into thin air, and no one would care or notice you ever were here. A puppet, an upstart, a loser who's destined to fall. I'm everything you always wanted to be. Let's deal with the issue, you wish you were me. You're nothing without me, without me, you're nothing.
And all right, already, I'm just an old goodnik. All right, already, it's true. So new, so sue me, sue me. What can you do me? I love...
You're at it again. You're running the game. I'm not gonna play second fiddle to that, and I'm sick and I'm tired of strolling around, and I'm telling you now that we're through. When I think of the time gone by,
Adelaide.
When I think of the way I try, I could honestly die.
Sue me, sue me. What can you do me? I love priest. Have a little priest.
Is it really good?
Sir, it's too good, at least. Then again, they don't commit sins of the flesh, so it's pretty fresh.
Awful lot of fat.
Only where it's sat.
Haven't you got poet or something like that?
Now you see, the trouble with poet is, how do you know it's deceased? Try the priest.
To be Alistoc, please stop this song. I'm got me wrong. I'd say so long. I'm not as strong a person as you think.
We can do
Mr.
it.
Mr. B. Alistoc, just take a look.
It.
I'm not a
say
crook. I'm just a snook. The bottom line is
cool.
That I stink.
We can do
I
it.
Can
we can do
it.
It. Up together we will soon.
We will soon.
We were fated to be mated. We're B. Alistoc and Gloom.
Please, take our advice. We aren't the Lunts.
I'm not Fanny Bryce.
Mama, we'll buy you the rice.
If only this once, you wouldn't think twice. It could be so nice if Mama got married to stay.
But Mama gets married.
And
married.
And
married.
And never gets carried away. Oh, Mama, get married. I longed for the day she'd turn and see me standing there.
Would God have let her stay?
Beside you is where I...
because I knew you. Because I knew you.
Because I knew you, I have been changed for good. Isn't it grand? Isn't it great? Isn't it swell? Isn't it fun? Isn't it? But nothing stays. In 15 minutes or so, the world will end, you know. But oh, it's heaven in Lily's eyes.
Oh my God.
Nice.
Wow.
That was incredible.
I think we got it all out.
Yeah, you hit pretty much every duet.
Yeah.
That was like the last duets on Earth.
Yes, that was the goal. That was the cue.
There are no more.
Yeah.
We want to ask you, we're each going to ask you a question.
A question.
Sure.
Yeah. It's Brooks Brothers.
Oh, yeah, that was... Greg...
It's beautiful.
No, really, you look really sharp,
Jess. Yeah, you guys
look
fantastic.
They're rentals.
Greg, I want to know, a regret question. Is there anywhere on Earth that you regret not having seen with your human eyes?
Oh, wow. Probably the polar ice caps, but I mean, even if I went there a couple weeks ago, they...
Oh, wow.
Greg.
So dark, yeah. Greg.
Really?
Yeah.
You want to go... That's what you want to see?
I want to see them, yeah.
Sorry, that's not going to
Are you
happen.
Judging my...
No. This is your last night.
No, it's your last night. I just, like, Jesus I didn't Christ. See you as an ice cap
yeah.
guy.
Yeah.
That's fine.
You've never been to Fire Island either, but that might also be too late.
Wow. You've never been to Fire Island?
I never have. I've never been invited. Sorry.
Never been invited?
No.
Okay, John.
Awkward. Moving on. Ask John, yeah.
John, is there anything that you, since you're not going to be able to do it, that you really wish you could have done before you die tonight?
I think I just did it.
Oh.
Oh, good. We're glad we could provide that for you.
We love you guys.
Love you.
We love you.
We'll see you at the after party.
Yeah.
Okay, great.
Oh, yeah,
great.
Yeah.
Okay, see you there.
You leave those. Take yeah, you take that.
Here, I got this one.
Oh, you leave that. And leave that. Yeah. Greg Hildreth and John Riddle, everybody. That was wonderful.
That was beautiful.
How's everyone doing? Anyone scared? You feeling excited? Anticipatory?
Did anyone eat the French fries yet? Because
they're really good here. The thin, crispy vinegar fries. I just want French fries till I die.
Okay.
That's me, anyway. Okay. Yeah. Say that these are not the best of times, but they're the only times I've ever known. And I believe there is a time for meditation in cathedrals of our own. Now I have seen that sad surrender in my lover's eyes. I can only stand apart and sympathize, for we are always what our situations hand us. It's either sadness or euphoria.
So we'll argue and we'll compromise and realize nothing's ever changed. For all our mutual experience, our separate conclusions are the same. Now we are forced to recognize our inhumanity. Our reason coexists with our insanity. And as we choose between reality and madness, it's either sadness or euphoria. How thoughtlessly we dissipate our energy.
we don't fulfill each other's fantasies. And as we stand upon the ledges of our lives with our respective similarities, it's either sadness or euphoria. Of our lives with our respective similarities. It's either sadness or euphoria.
Billy Joel, everybody. What? Shit. Don't check your phone during the show. That's important. Rude. Okay.
Okay. Can we turn the news? We have a news update.
Oh.
Can we turn the news on?
We just want to keep you all informed.
Thanks, Tyler.
Good evening, New York. I'm Sheila Bucket.
And I'm gay. I mean, I'm blind. I mean, I'm Dax Von Carmichael Bartholomew Davenport XIV.
The mega tsunami set to destroy much of humanity has turned into nothing more than a tiny wave.
Oh, so we're safe.
No, because a newly discovered asteroid moving 17,403 miles per hour is hurtling toward Earth and expected to make landfall at Joe's Pub and will destroy most of humanity.
So we're
still all gonna fucking die.
Jesus fucking
yes.
Christ.
Up next, finger cancer. It's easier to get than you think and very, very deadly. Find out what exercises you can do to avoid it after the break. This doesn't seem important.
Oh my gosh.
Wow,
I thought we were fine for a second there.
So we're not going to be killed by a tsunami. There's going to be an asteroid that's going to hit Joe's Pub.
Honestly, that seems better in a way because
it's
like an immediate because with the tsunami there's a chance some of us are going to survive.
Yeah.
And have to like swim our way to safety.
It's all dark.
Do you know what I think?
Play a game.
We need to play a game.
Yeah.
We're
going
to play a game.
Yeah. We're going to play
everyone's favorite stick your hand in a hole and guess what's in their game show.
What's in Matt's hole?
What's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's big old hole? We're asking, what's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole?
Wow, there's something in my hole?
Yeah, we put something in your hole before the show.
I had no idea.
Well, we wanted to surprise you, yeah.
I literally wasn't aware that you guys put something in my hole. That is so crazy.
Yeah, it's pretty fun, though. Someone's going to get to reach in there.
What's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole?
Sing along.
What's in Matt's big old hole? We're asking, what's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole?
Here's how it works. We're going to need one lucky volunteer from the audience. Let's see some hands.
Come on.
Who wants to come up here? Reach inside Matt's hole.
We just got this guy right
here. No, this guy right there. Yeah, you, sir.
You?
No, you. In the middle of the booth, right there.
All right, you back there.
Okay, wait, no, sorry, sir, behind you. Yeah, back there. Come on, you're faster. Come on up here. You, sir, are going to reach.
Oh, I know this guy. Hi, Connie.
Oh, my God, it's our friend Connie.
Oh, my God, Connie.
Connie, you get to reach inside Matt's hole on the last night on Earth.
Yeah.
Okay, so what's going to happen is you... Hi.
Hi.
Happy New Year. Happy last night on Earth. You're going to reach your hand right here inside Matt's hole. Show it around to everybody. This is Matt's hole. You're going to reach your hand inside Matt's hole, and you're going to get one theme song's worth of time to guess what's in there. So you're just going to jam your hand right in the hole. Just stick your hand right in Matt's hole. I'll move back here so all of you can see.
Matt's hole, what's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's big old hole? We're asking, what's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole? What's in Matt's hole?
Okay.
Give it a squeeze. Give it a squeeze if you're not sure.
Do I take it out?
Well, no, you just guess.
Okay.
There's a cash prize.
Lots of money.
It's disgusting.
Okay. Did you squeeze it?
I squeezed
judging.
It.
He squeezed it.
Oh, God. Is it a donut with cream inside?
Kinda, actually.
Sort of.
I think that's it.
That's it. You got it. Okay, pull your hand out. It's kind of sharp. Matt's hole's sharp. Oh, yeah. So it was a hostess snowball, everybody.
I'm so sorry. There's napkins at the table, but wait.
That's okay. There's napkins at your table. That's fine. But you win this giant blank check.
And you can...
You
can make it out to any amount you want, okay? And to whoever you want, because it's the end of the world and money doesn't matter.
Money doesn't even matter anymore. So you just get to have this. Write yourself check. No, you have to take that with you.
You can eat it, too.
You just get... Could someone get Connie a napkin?
Yeah.
Not me, though. I don't want to be a part of it.
You.
Okay, love you.
Happy haul.
Wow.
One more. One last one to celebrate. What's in that hole?
What's in that hole? What's in that big old hole? We're asking, what's in that hole? What's in that hole? What's in that hole?
Yeah.
Wow.
You guys can play that at home if you want.
Yeah, play it at home. Just stick your hand. You'd have to be there.
Oh, that's small.
Invite him over. The world's over, Matt. There's no more holes.
That's true.
This
I forgot.
The last
I'm sorry.
Hole.
I forgot about it. Okay, anyway.
It's okay. We're
it's,
doing
hard,
great.
It's hard to remember sometimes.
Oh,
okay.
It's time for another freaking commercial. Corporate America breathing down our necks. Okay, this one's a pharmaceutical. Did an apocalyptic event trap you inside a room with no windows and no doors and no food or drink or way of getting out?
Yes.
Well, that's why I drink my own urine.
My own urine, wow.
Your own urine?
No, my own urine.
Oh.
My own urine has just enough ingredients to get you through another day of waiting to be rescued. Here, have a taste.
No, that's okay. I think I'll just wait until I'm really desperate.
My own urine, wow.
My own urine, available at your urinary tract. My own urine is a special bottle that we sell you for the low price of $49.99 that you fill with your own literal piss. Your piss is not included.
My own urine, wow.
Wow, that is dark.
I just gave it away. Oh, I gave the urine.
It's delicious.
You should try it if
and
you want.
And it's fresh.
It's really fresh. It's cooled off a little, though. It was hot before.
It depends. You know, some people like you microwave it if you want it to be a little warm.
You could nuke it.
Nuke it. Okay, you guys, so we have another guest.
Another special guest.
Yeah.
This is one of my favorite people. I just love her so dearly.
And I only just met her, but I'm a big fan. I've seen her in many things.
Yeah, she's wonderful. You've probably seen her if you are cultured at all. If you've seen TV or Broadway in the last 15 years. Please welcome to the stage, Rebecca Naomi Jones. We want to ask you some end of days question or two.
Great.
Some question.
Yeah, okay.
Do you have one? We're pulling these out of our butts. Does anyone have a question for Rebecca?
I would say, is there... Oh, God.
What's your favorite smell? What are you going to miss? What's your favorite smell on Earth?
Okay, there's this... This is really specific, but there's this smell in Southern California on these hikes that I've taken.
Oh, I know exactly what you're talking about.
Yeah.
It's California sagebrush.
That's it?
Yeah, I know
it's
it.
It's so beautiful, and like I when I know that I'm going to go on these hikes, my nose starts to like... get ready for it. Like, it's just so beautiful.
I would love to smell that right now because I feel like it would bring back like a time in my life when I lived in California.
Yeah, now but you'll never smell it again.
Yeah. Wow. Okay. Sorry, we were going to keep it light, guys, and we just keep bringing it down. But life is good. Life is great. What do you have what are you looking forward to in the afterlife?
Oh, my. Also could be dark, but I mean it in a good way. Seeing my dad again.
Oh. Yeah. See, there's pros to death, you guys.
There's pros.
Rebecca, you have a really cool song. This is a Shayna Taub number.
Yes, this is an amazing Shayna Taub song. Shayna can really write a hook, y'all.
And you want audience participation if possible.
Yeah. I mean, most of you probably don't know the song, but it's like once you get it, just come on, get in.
Okay.
It's going to make it the way it needs to be.
We're going to leave you to it.
Celebrate. We're going to leave you. Rebecca Naomi Jones, everybody. Give her some love.
Wait. Can I actually do this one? I rehearsed on this one. Sorry. Okay.
Now preachers and teachers and scholarly brains have tried to provide a truth that explains why shit can go so badly. Well, I've had my serving or two of the blues, but I go back for seconds or thirds, 'cause I choose to stomach sorrow gladly. For I have a theory which might sound crass, but to that hypothesis I'll raise a glass. Here's to the chaos, the heartache and strain. Three cheers for agony, a toast to the pain. Hats off to everything that leaves a scar. Harden souls to granite. For when at the end of a harrowing day, you see who shows up at your doorstep to say, here's to the chaos, the heartache, the heartache.
Rebecca. Oh, that was amazing. So this is crazy, but we have a surprise guest. I just ran into her in the alleyway. She was smoking a cigarette. And I asked her, would you want to just come in and like say hello to everyone? And she said, actually, I have a new pop song. that she'd like to perform for you. She isn't really usually a pop singer, but she's a supermodel. You guys know her. I was super starstruck when I just saw her. She's so cool. Everyone, please welcome to the stage Antarctica.
Hey, everybody. I'm actually so happy to be here doing this charity event for poor people.
It's not a charity event. It's the last night on Earth. We're gonna be hit by an asteroid. We're gonna die, and we all gathered here to celebrate life.
No, I'm actually going on a rocket to new planet.
Oh.
I don't have last night for me, so sorry.
Oh, got it. Okay.
That's okay. Well, that's okay. But
so you're living. So you're gonna live.
You have to stay here. You don't have rockets.
We're all, everyone in this room is going to die.
Oh my
tonight,
God.
Except for you. So congratulations.
No, that's okay. My life will be really good, but you guys all have to die. That's okay.
So what are these?
But, no, I brought this to do. This is my limited edition, this magazine from maybe like 10 years ago. But I autographed to auction for the poor people, for you guys.
We don't need money. Money doesn't exist anymore. So if you want to give them out.
No silent auction. Okay, well, but for free?
Just give. Yeah.
Do you know, actually, my friend, do you know Big E?
Oh, yeah.
He always be telling me, like, if you have more money, you have more problems.
Right.
So
yes,
that's okay,
that
actually. Money is fine. But anybody want to have copy of magazine?
Yeah, pass them out.
I don't know how to give. You go, or after the show, you can make a lot of money, put on eBay or something, be, like, really expensive. So everybody, you know me because I've been international world famous supermodel for my whole life basically. But recently I am making a pop song. This is dance club pop song that is triple platinum European sort of worldwide hit. So I present to you tonight, this is my hit song, Discotheque. Discotheque, discotheque, at the discotheque, oh, 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 disco, 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 tech, 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 dancing at the club with my friends. This is one hell of a party. I hope tonight is never ends, because I really love to dance. Only famous people are here. Everybody doing drugs now. Just kidding, we would never break the law. But if we did, we wouldn't get in trouble. If you can't get in the club, you probably are not famous. This is a club for the humblest people. So if your dancing moves are the hottest dancing moves in the world. Actors, models, drinking bottles, coolest kids are hanging here. Everything is so expensive, everybody's really rich. All the dance moves are so hot and everybody is so good. Everybody comes here to dance cause they love to dance. To dance, to dance, to dance, 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 dance. Discotheque, discotheque, at the discotheque, oh, 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 disco, 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 disco. When I think back to my mother, she was always dancing. I was born at the disco, and I immediately start to dance. I was born to dance at the discotheque. I was born at the discotheque. I am living my life at the discotheque because I really love to dance. Everybody come and dance. This is exclusive club only for dance. Discotheque, discotheque,
Disco, 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 disco.
Turn them on, leave them burning, then you're gone. Looking out for another, anyone will do. You're in the mood for a dance. And when you get the chance, you are the dancing queen, young and sweet, only 17. Dancing queen, feel the beat from the tambourine. Oh yeah, you can dance, you can jive, having the time of your life. Ooh, see that girl, watch that scene, dig in the dancing queen, dig in the dancing queen.
Cusack, everybody.
Matt Cusack worked so hard with us the past week.
He really did.
So
he helped us rehearse for The Last Night on Earth just so much. Thanks, Matt.
Thank you, Matt.
Nothing to lose. That's right. Low stakes, high stakes. Super high stakes, but also very low stakes.
Right. Well, we're about to die, but also
because of that, who gives a flying dinkle of a dongle? That's right.
We have another commercial.
Oh, gosh, another. These advertisers. Up our butts, right?
It's the last one. Though,
okay, so. It's the last one. Oh, my God. This one looks long. I'll do the first line.
Okay.
In these unprecedented times, now more than ever, when the world feels like it's falling apart more than ever before, we know you're scared, and we're scared too. But we can get through this if we do it together.
And that's why Olive Garden is offering the very last never-ending pasta bowl, now with crystal meth.
Of course.
Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl, now with crystal meth.
For
a limited time, since time is literally limited, come in and enjoy all you can eat pasta, sauce, toppings, soup, salad, breadsticks, and so much more, all laced with crystal meth. So you can eat delicious food, do meth, and completely dissociate from reality.
Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl, now with crystal meth.
You know, I've always heard that meth can give you one of the most incredibly euphoric highs, but I was too scared to try it because I know it's also very addictive and can do crazy things to you, like make your teeth fall out and cause you to have tremors and paranoia and seizures and even die. But now that the world is ending, I guess it just doesn't matter anymore. And what better place to do meth than Olive Garden, right?
Sir, would you like more pasta?
No, but I will have more of that sweet crank.
Each meal is for one person and may not be shared. Not all menu items may be available as Earth's food supply has been decimated by catastrophic wildfires and flooding. Olive Garden is not responsible for the end of the world, but let's just say it's not responsible. Gratuity is not included.
Olive Garden's never-ending pasta bowl, now with crystal meth.
Woo. To be honest, that one sounded great to me. All the rest, I was unsure, but the crystal meth and the breadsticks, I'm in. So we're doing something, you know when you watch the Oscars, there's always that in memoriam section? Okay, I learned yesterday it's pronounced in memoriam, but I do want to just admit and say that I think it's in memoriam. For some reason, that's what it is. So for our In Memoriam tonight, we are going to pay tribute to all the celebrities who are about to die. So we've put together a sort of a slideshow, and we're gonna have a beautiful song, and we're just gonna honor all of the famous people we know and love who are about to kick the bucket, as are we. No offense to us. Oh, and here to sing her single from her most recent album, Missing You, pop sensation Robin.
Hi, I'm Robin. Baby, it's so real to me now that it's over. The place where you used to be, your head on my shoulder. All of the plans we made that never happened. Now your scent on my pillow's faded. At least you left me with something. There's this empty space you left behind. Now you're not here with me. I keep digging through our waste of time, but the picture's incomplete. 'Cause I'm missing you. Yeah. I miss you.
She made it.
Can't make sense of all of the pieces of my own delusions. Can't take all these memories, don't know how to use them. There's a slick washed up onto the beach, I follow the traces. Finding clues in my pockets and opening boxes and going places we went. Remember to forget, thinking how it could have been. Turn all my sorrow into glass. It don't leave no shadow. There's this empty space you left behind. Now you're not here with me. I keep digging through our waste of time, but the picture's incomplete, 'cause I'm missing you. I miss you. This part of you, this pot that stopped, this residue, it's all I've got.
There's this empty space you left behind.
This clock that stopped.
I keep thinking you're still right beside me.
It's all I've got.
There's this empty space you left behind. All the love you gave, it still defines me. There's this empty space you left behind. All the love you gave, it still defines me. Thank you. I'm Robin.
Wow, very moving, Robin. Thank you. Oh, Matt, you're back. Matt's back, everyone. Oh, you didn't miss anything. Just the in memorarium section.
Memorium.
No. We talked about it, and everyone agrees that it sounds better in memorarium, right?
I'm going to keep these on. Actually, I think someone who I stole these from, Halloween of 2019,
is here
tonight. So thank you for the
costume. Sorry about that. So... I just heard my phone vibrate.
Oh, you did?
I did.
Crazy.
And I think there's a news update. Oh, I don't have it on me, but I heard it.
Can we get the news?
Can we get the news? Maybe? Can we roll the news? We think there might be more information about the asteroid. Just another update here.
Good evening. I'm Sheila Bucket.
And I have a confession.
As earlier reported, an asteroid is hurtling toward our planet.
I am not Dax von Carmichael Bartholomew Davenport XIV. I'm his twin. 21 years ago, I murdered Dax and assumed his identity to avoid prison for tax evasion. I invited him over, put a bunch of sleeping pills in his wine, dressed him in my clothes, made it look like I committed suicide, and then I took over his identity and life. And I'm sorry. I wanted to make sure I got it all off my chest before we all die, since the world is ending. Mm-hmm. That feels good.
NASA has updated us that the asteroid will not be making impact with Earth, and therefore humanity will not be destroyed.
But something else catastrophic is going to happen, though, right? Like a nuclear weapon is heading our way or something, right?
Not today, no. In other news, water. You drink it every day, and there's a good chance it's slowly killing you. Why? Find out after the break.
God,
wow,
so we're not gonna die.
Guys, we're just gonna live.
Oh my God.
Wow. I'm having mixed feelings right now because I'd really like psyched myself up for death. I'd gotten kind of excited about it.
I was ready to die.
I've been maxing out my credit cards for the last couple months.
But
and
now,
I felt good about not having to pay for them.
Now you can pay all that money to the government.
That's right. That's a pro. No, but now we do get to do all the things that we loved about being alive.
Yeah. Like I should like be calling my mother more. I should
connecting
be,
with family.
Yeah.
Oysters, the most delicious food. French fries. For me, they're mostly food related. Oysters, French fries, pizza, sunsets, sunrises.
I also just wanted to mention that there's someone whose birthday it is here tonight.
Oh, that's right. There's a birthday tonight.
And he thought he was gonna die. And he came here to spend his last night.
Birthday. His last day and birthday here
and
with us.
Anyway, is
Manesh? Manesh!
Should we sing a happy birthday to him really
Should
quick?
Should we do a quick happy birthday for Manesh?
All right.
So, wait, here's something I learned recently. The first note of happy birthday is the lowest.
Okay.
And most people start it too high, and then it gets crazy. So that's just a tip for you. So now that you're going to live and have hopefully many more birthdays to celebrate. So... Debbie, will you give us like a lower note? Yeah. We're gonna start there. Happy birthday to you. Happy birthday to you.
And you're not gonna die.
Happy birthday, Manesh, dear Manesh. Happy birthday to you. All congrats on getting to live another day because the world could end at any moment. Like, shit's been crazy regardless of the asteroid and the tsunami that we're miraculously headed right for Joe's Pub.
So it's the end of the show, and we're going to leave you, I guess, with that.
We're going to leave you with a
a closing number.
All right.
It's not the last night on earth, but it's the end of the show, so we'll still say goodbye. We had some fun, we got to celebrate, and guess what? Nobody fucking died. That's right, nobody fucking died.
John Riddle, my lover.
Rebecca Naomi Jones.
And to our wonderful band.
Matt Cusack.
Vince Federici.
Debbie Gong on piano. Chris Schultz on the drums. And we've got Steve and Tyler up in the booth. Amazing on sound and light.
And all of you. And
all
remember,
of you.
Remember, your life is happening right now.
Live it. Have some fun. Go crazy. Do something you've been scared to do.
Do things you were scared of. Say I love you to the person that you've always wanted to say it.
Yeah, flash someone tonight on your way home. That always gets things going.
That might be bad.
That without consent. Flash them if they want to see your tits. Otherwise, keep them in your shirt.
Because eventually...
You could flash your butt. You could flash your butt because everyone has a butt.
That's true.
That's just something I thought of. Sorry. And then it's fine because everyone has a butt. Anyway, eventually... We're all gonna motherfucking die. Thank you all for being here. We're gonna have a drink in the library after this. So meet us in the library. They're gonna stay open for a drink if you want. And just have fun, okay? We gotta go.